नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। हरे कृष्णा। सो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी प्रेजेंट अमंग्स ऑल द एस्टीम डिवोटीज ऑफ इस्कॉन भागवत महाविद्यालय एंड स्पेशली आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ ऑल द सीनियर वैष्णवाज हु आर प्रेजेंट हियर, हिज ग्रेट श्रीवास प्रभु, जगदात्मा प्रभु, इंद्र नीलमणि प्रभु, सत्य नरसिंह प्रभु। सो ऑल्दो टुडेज टॉपिक इज वेरी लॉफ्टी, इट इज द ग्लोरी ऑफ द सुरक्षेण क्षेत्र और मथुरा मंडल, एंड आई एम नॉट क्वालिफाइड टू स्पीक अबाउट दिस लॉफ्टी टॉपिक, बट जस्ट टू ग्लोरीफाई श्रीमद् भागवतम, द धाम ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड एंड हिज डिवोटीज, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू रेंडर दिस सर्विस टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो ऑल ऑफ यू प्लीज ब्लेस मी दैट वॉट एवर आई स्पीक इज फॉर द ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। वॉट एवर गुड विल कम आउट ऑफ दिस, द ग्लोरी गोज टू माई गुरुदेव, एंड वॉट एवर द मिस्टेक्स, दोज आर माइन, सो प्लीज डोंट कैरी देम बैक, लीव देम हियर। हरे कृष्ण। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 1 टेक्स्ट नंबर 27 एंड 28। सो फर्स्ट वील रीड बोथ द वर्सेस, द ट्रांसलेशंस, एंड देन वील डिस्कस सम सेलियंट पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम आचार्यस कॉमेंटरीज, एंड देन वील हियर अबाउट द ग्लोरीज ऑफ मथुरा मंडल एंड श्री वृंदावन धाम। So kindly repeat after me. I am reading text 27. Shuraseno yadupatir Mathura mavasan purim Mathuran shurasenamscha Vishayan bubuje para। So the word-to-word meaning goes like this. Shurasenaha, King Shurasena, Yadupatihi, the chief of the Yadu dynasty, Mathuram, at the place known as Mathura, Avasan, went to live, Purim, in that city, Mathuran, at the place known as Mathura district, Shurasenan, Shurasenancha, and the place known as Shurasen, Vishayan, such kingdoms, Bubuje, enjoyed, Pura, formerly. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Formerly, Shurasena, the chief of the Yadu dynasty, had gone to live in the city of Mathura. There he enjoyed the places known as Mathura and Shurasena. I'll repeat the translation. Formerly, Shurasena, the chief of the Yadu dynasty, had gone to live in the city of Mathura. There he enjoyed the places known as Mathura and Shurasena. So from this verse onwards till the end of this chapter, Shukadev Goswami is setting the scene for the advent of Lord Krishna. So he is setting the scene, he is telling the introductory pastimes which lead up to the advent of Lord Krishna. So till now we have seen that Mother Earth was consoled by Lord Brahma, and now Mother Devaki will be consoled. But before that, Shukadev Goswami wants to explain that what troubles did Devaki go through. After that, she will be consoled. So the acharyas say that this Shurasena, which is referred to here, this Shurasena is actually not the Shurasena who is the father of Vasudev. This Shurasena came many, many generations before Vasudev, and the Shurasena who is father of Vasudev. So this Shurasena is actually one of the five sons who remained alive in the battle of Kartavirya Arjun. He is son of Kartavirya Arjun. This is explained in the 9th canto. And Kartavirya Arjun gave one of his sons, whose name is Shurasena, the kingdom of Mathura and also Shurasena. Jiva Goswami explains that actually there is no difference between these two regions. These are the two same regions, the Shurasena region and the Mathura Mandal. So formerly the Mathura Mandal, the kingdom of Mathura, was established by the brother of Lord Ram, Shatrughna. So this is the background of this verse. We'll read the next verse. Rajadhani tatha sabhut sarvayadava bubujam Mathura Bhagavan yatra nityam sannihito harihi Rajadhani tataha sabhut sarvayadava bhubujam Mathura Bhagavan yatra nityam sannihito harihi. So the word-to-word meaning goes like this. Rajadhani, the capital, tataha, from that time, sa, the country and the city known as Mathura, abhut, became sarva yadava bhubujam, of all the kings who appeared in the Yadu dynasty. Mathura, the place known as Mathura. Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yatra, wherein, nityam, eternally, sannitaha, intimately connected. Harihi, the Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So the translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Since that time, the city of Mathura had been the capital of all the kings of the Yadu dynasty. The city and district of Mathura are very intimately connected with Krishna, for Lord Krishna lives there eternally. Purport. It is understood that Mathura city is the transcendental abode of Lord Krishna. It is not an ordinary material city, for it is eternally connected with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Vrindavan is within the jurisdiction of Mathura, and it still continues to exist. Because Mathura and Vrindavan are intimately connected with Krishna eternally, it is said that Lord Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Vrindavanam parityajya padamekam nagacchati. At present, the place known as Vrindavan in the district of Mathura continues its position as a transcendental place. And certainly, anyone who goes there becomes transcendentally purified. Navadvip Dham is also intimately connected with Brajabhumi. Srila Narottam Das Thakur therefore says, Shri Gaura Mandala Bhumi Ye Bajane Chintamani Tarahaya Vrajabhume Vasa. Vrajabhumi refers to Mathura Vrindavan and Gaura Mandala Bhumi includes Navadvip. These two places are non-different. Therefore, anyone living in Navadvip Dham, knowing Krishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to be the same personality, lives in Vrajabhumi, Mathura Vrindavan. The Lord has made it convenient for the conditioned soul to live in Mathura, Vrindavan and Navadvip and thus be directly connected with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Simply by living in these places, one can immediately come in contact with the Lord. So we'll discuss the later part of the purport after some time. I would just like to share some points from the commentaries of Acharyas here. So regarding this verse, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur is saying, Krishna, the Lord in person, who is the most complete, is already continuously abiding in his own abode. So here the verse says that Lord Krishna is living in Mathura eternally. So Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur is saying that Lord Krishna is eternally staying here. It is not that when his avirbhav happens or when he takes birth, then he is in Mathura and then he goes to Vrindavan. Not like that. He is always in Mathura. So he becomes visible in this material world, but it is not that he descends after coming from somewhere in Vaikuntha. Moreover, at the time of his avirbhav, his amshas, having come from Vaikuntha, Shvetadvip and so on, merge in him and at the conclusion of his pastimes on earth return to their respective abodes. So all the amshas, including all the Vishnu forms, they merge or they combine in the body of Krishna. They come here when Krishna's avirbhav happens. And when his pastimes are over, they go back to their respective planets. So there is never a time when Krishna is not present in Mathura. Furthermore, Jiva Goswami says that he who has all Aishwarya, he is saying about Krishna, he who has all Aishwarya, which cannot be properly defined since he is the Lord in person, Hari, which means he captures everyone's hearts with his form, virtues, pastimes and sweetness, which cannot be properly defined, abides near those who live there. So this is again Jiva Goswami is confirming that Lord Krishna always lives near those who live in Mathura. He is always living there. And regarding Mathura, there is a very interesting statement in the Padma Puran. It says, Aho Madhupuri Dhanya Vaikunthacha Gariyasi, which means Mathurapuri is blessed and is more venerable than Vaikuntha. So we see in Upadeshamrita also, there is a list of places which is given by Rupa Goswami who have their importance in an increasing order. So here in this verse, it was said that Mathura Mandal is higher than Vaikuntha planets. And then in Upadeshamrit, we read, Rupa Goswami is writing there, Vaikuntha janito vara madhupuri tatra tirasotsavad vrindaranyam udara pani ramana tatrapi govardhanaha. So we have all read this in Upadeshamrit, that higher than Mathura, higher than Vaikuntha is Mathurapuri. And why is Mathura higher than Vaikuntha? Because Lord Krishna took birth there. And higher than Mathura is Vrindavan. Why? Because the festival of Rasalila is always going on there. And higher than Vrindavan is Sri Giri Govardhan. Why is that? Because the Lord Himself lifted Govardhan on His little finger. So like this, the list continues. Higher than Govardhan is Radhakund. So Mathura Mandal is definitely a part of this universe as we see it. At the same time, when the pralaya happens, when the water of the ocean rises through all the planetary systems, even at that time, Mathurapuri is not destroyed. And the Lord continues to stay here. So this land of Mathura and Vrindavan are most glorious. They have descended directly from the spiritual world for the benefit of all the fallen souls, conditioned souls of this material world, so that they can directly get connected to Lord Krishna, as Srila Prabhupada is saying here in the purport. And Srila Prabhupada further says here in the purport that anybody who executes devotional service in these places certainly goes back home, back to Godhead, after giving up this body. So this is certainly a statement which should make us thrilled. This information should make us thrilled. Prabhupada is saying, anyone who executes devotional service in these places certainly goes back home, back to Godhead. So the glory of Vrindavan and all the unlimited holy places present here is unlimited. And although it is unlimited, it is described by our Vaishnava Acharyas. So Vrindavan is a place, or Mathura Mandal, Brajbhumi, it's a place where great Acharyas have performed tapasya. Great Acharyas and great devotees, like Dhruva Maharaj has performed tapasya. And even the creator of this material universe and the Acharya of our Sampradaya, Brahma, he wants to take birth in this land of Vrindavan. And he wants to take birth just as some inanimate mountain, you know, so that the residents of Vrindavan can climb on his head and leave the dust of their feet on his head. So he takes birth in Barsana, and his four heads become the four mountain peaks of Mangad, Dangad, Bhangad, and Vilasgad. And when Lord Shiva sees this, he is also feeling greedy. He thinks that Lord Brahma has taken birth in such a wonderful way. Let me also take birth as a mountain. So I'll take birth in the village of Krishna. So he takes birth as the Nandishwar Parvat. And even Lord Vishnu, he takes birth as a mountain. Who is he? Giriraj Maharaj ki jai. So in Garga Samhita it says, Girirajo Hare Rupam. Giriraj is non-different from Lord Hari. So all the great personalities are doing tapasya here, and they want to take birth here. They want to take a very insignificant and humble birth here, because they all know the glories of Vrindavan, the glory of the resident of Vrindavan. And just like Uddhava is there, Uddhava is a very, very highly qualified person. He is a disciple of Brihaspati himself. And after having all these qualifications, he is an intimate associate of Lord Krishna. He is a disciple of Brihaspati. And actually, he knows everything which Brihaspati knows. Plus, he knows one more subject which Brihaspati does not know. That subject is, do you know what is that? That subject is Vraja Prema Tattva. He knows that. So, because of that, Lord Krishna sends him to counsel the gopis. And even when he comes here, he says that, I just want to become some Gulmalata Aushadi here, you know, some Lata, some Aushadi, where the gopis will walk on my head. So, all the great personalities, whether they are sadhus or great kings, they are doing tapasya here and they want to take birth here. And this great opportunity, which is very, very rarely obtained, is been given to all of us. So we have to understand the importance and utilize this great opportunity very wisely. So even Narad Muni, when he came here and saw the Rasalila, he wanted to become a gopi. So he takes bath in the Kusum Sarovar and he becomes the Naradi gopi. And when Lord Shiva sees this, he also becomes greedy. He also wants to participate in the Rasila pastimes. So Lord Shiva takes bath in the Manas Sarovar and becomes Gopishwar Mahadev. So all these great personalities are somehow or other trying to enter this great Mathura Mandal, Vrindavan Mandal. We all know that Lakshmi Devi is still meditating in Belvan and still she has not received entry in the Rasa Leela. So Srila Prabhupada said that in Vrindavan there are 5,000 temples. Prabhupada said this in the 1970s, now there are more. So, but there are 5,000 temples and for Gaudiya Vaishnavas, 7 are most prominent. And out of those 7, 3 are even more prominent. So these 3 are Madan Mohanji, Radha Govindji and Radha Gopinath. So Madan Mohan is the deity of Sambandha. Then Gopinath, Govinda is the deity of Abhidheya. And Gopinath is the deity of Prayojan. So Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati says that Madan Mohan, all these three deities have different duties or jobs to attract conditioned souls. So Madan Mohan attracts the conditioned souls initially. The initial attraction to Krishna is given by Madan Mohan. And Radha Govinda, who is the Abhideya Devata, he gives service to the devotee. And Radha Gopinath, he perfects the devotee when he reaches the stage of Prema. So these three temples, which are constructed by our three prominent acharyas, are the main and most prominent temples. And Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati further says that there is one temple, there is one deity who has the characteristics of all these three. Which is that deity? Shri Shri Radha Raman. So, and that is the only deity which is still there in Vrindavan because it's a very small deity. So it can even be hidden somewhere. So when the attackers, the Mughals came, the deity could be hidden, and whereas the other deities had to be moved to Jaipur, Karoli and all the other places. So in his song Jai Radhe, Jai Krishna, Jai Vrindavan, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is explaining about the various places in Vrindavan. So he is explaining about Giriraj, about Yamuna. He takes the names of these places. Right now we are sitting at the lotus feet of Giriraj. So higher than Vrindavan is Giri Govardhan, and Giri Govardhan is considered as the tilak of Brajbhumi. He is the tilak of Brajbhumi, and the local Brajvasis who are staying here in Giriraj, they say that how great our Giriraj is. You know, when Indra came and there were torrents of rain and there were thunderbolts falling everywhere, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, what did he do? He had to take shelter of our Giriraj. That's what they say. So that is Haridaswarya Giriraj. Of course, the Brajvasis say like this, but Krishna is the supreme cause of everything, and whatever he does in Braja is ultimately to facilitate the meeting with Radharani. So why did he lift Giriraj? Actually, he lifted to get association of all the Brajvasis for 7 days, and especially Radharani. So it is explained in the commentaries of Acharyas that when the torrential rain started, the Samvartaka clouds came, and the downpour began. The rain was falling like pillars, you know, the raindrops were like pillars of water. So Krishna lifted the Govardhan hill, and initially his hand was, you know, a little bit shaking while he had lifted the hill. And so the news spread everywhere that the son of Nanda Maharaj is trapped, you know, below the Govardhan hill. He needs some help. So everybody should come with their sticks and give support to the hill so that it doesn't fall down, you know. So all the Brajvasis, they don't consider Krishna as Supreme Personality of Godhead. They think he is our friend or, you know, our child. So the news also went to Barsana, and it went to Vrishabhanu Maharaj. And Vrishabhanu Maharaj said, oh, please, let's collect all the people, all the men, and let's go to Giriraj. And we should all carry our sticks together with us, and we'll go and support the hill, so that Krishna is not hurt. And this is all Krishna's plan, actually, to meet Radharani. So when Vrishabhanu Maharaj and Kirtida and all the residents of Barsana, they went, they started going towards Giriraj. So definitely they can't leave their daughter alone. So they took Radharani also along. And meanwhile, Krishna was holding the Govardhan hill, and his hand was a little bit shaking. And the friends were telling, Krishna, see, you don't have enough strength to lift Govardhan, you know. So let us help you. We'll support the Govardhan hill with our sticks. So Krishna said, yeah, please support. Actually, Krishna was waiting for Radharani so that he could, you know, show his demonstration, how he can hold Giriraj effortlessly. So till the time Radharani didn't arrive, he was not in, you know, best mood to give his A grade performance. And then when Radharani arrived with the residents of Barsana, then Krishna saw that now the audience has come. Now I should give the best performance. So immediately Krishna lifted Giriraj without, you know, any effortlessly, like a feather. And even Giriraj was not shaking. There was no vibration in Krishna's hands. So everything was perfect when the audience arrived. But now when Radharani came, because of looking at Radharani, Krishna developed some ecstatic symptoms. And his hand again started shaking, you know. So the Brajvasis got worried that what's happening. And Mother Yashoda, out of her extremely pure motherly affection, she said to Giriraj in great anger, Giriraj, my son's hand is shaking. if you increase your weight even by 1 ounce, I'll burn you with my, you know, motherly devotion. So Giriraj was looking, you know, what's happening right from the beginning, and he was thinking, what I have done? I have nothing to do with this. So anyway, when Mother Yashoda said this, Giriraj started floating 1 inch above Krishna's finger. He was floating, you know. Okay, Mother Yashoda, no problem, I am floating. So Giriraj was floating little above Krishna's finger, and suddenly Brajvasis are watching that, what's happening, you know. And Krishna was acting as if he is, you know, now very confident, he is not lifting anything. And some of his friends said, Krishna, see you. So Krishna saw, oh, Giriraj is floating, I am not holding. So immediately he put his finger little up and touched Giriraj. So like that, that is Giriraj Haridas Varya. And the same Giriraj, when he cries in separation of Krishna, his two eyes shed the tears of love. Which are the two eyes of Giriraj? They are Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. And the waters inside are not only the ecstasy of Radharani and Krishna, but they are also the ecstasy of separation of Giriraj himself. So they are the two eyes of Giriraj. So Giriraj is Haridas Varya, and he supplies to Krishna, cowherd friends and the gopis everything which is required for all of their pastimes. Now speaking of tears of ecstasy, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also describes Yamuna or Kalindi. Now Kalindi is the daughter of the Kalinda mountain. And she is a very, very special devotee of the Lord. She is very special because on the bank of Kalindi or Yamuna, Krishna's pastimes in all the rasas, they happen, they take place. Right from Shanta Rasa to Madhurya Rasa. Yamuna has Rasasthali. Yamuna is the banks of Yamuna have the grazing pastures. Then they are also the playing grounds for cowherd boys. So all the pastimes of Krishna in all the rasas, they take place on the bank of Yamuna. And also Krishna's pastimes in all the ages, right from the childhood to youth, they take place there. So in Padyavali, Rupa Goswami says, when Krishna is standing on top of Giri Govardhan, he looks like a dark monsoon cloud. When Krishna is standing in midst of Mother Yamuna, he looks like a newly blossomed blue lotus flower. And when Krishna is standing in the forest of Vrindavan, he looks like a dark tamal tree. So I'm not able to understand whether he is the monsoon cloud, he is the freshly blossomed lotus flower, or whether he is the tamal tree, Rupa Goswami is saying. But then he says, it doesn't matter whether he is the monsoon cloud, the lotus, or the tree. These three forms of Krishna should relieve me from my adidevik, adibhautik, and adhyatmik kleshas. So that is Rupa Goswami saying in Padyavali. So like this, there is description of so many holy places. We can't go in detail. The time is short. The description of Vamshivat comes, the place where Krishna plays his flute during Sharad Purnima. So during Sharad Purnima, all the millions and millions of gopis, all the gopis, whether the gopis are directly descended from Goloka, or whether they are devatas who are taken birth as gopis, or whether they are the rishis who have taken birth as gopis, all of them, they come and dance with Lord Krishna. And amongst them, the greatest gopi is Srimati Radharani. Prabodhanand Saraswati, he says that when will I get the chance to serve Srimati Radharani, by whose devotional service even Krishna's flute slips from his hands. You know, when Krishna is playing his flute, all the jivatmas and even the inanimate rocks and rivers, they are frozen. They become still, stunned. But when Lord Krishna sees Radharani's devotional service, his flute slips from his hand and still he continues to play, because he doesn't understand that the flute has slipped. He still continues to play. So his flute falls down, his peacock feather falls down, his yellow garments fall down, and when the devotional service of Radharani is over, Krishna himself falls down and he becomes unconscious. So Prabodhanand Saraswati has written many, many wonderful prayers in Vrindavan Mahimamrit, glorifying Sri Vrindavan Dham and the great fortune of staying in Vrindavan Mathura Mandal. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, Yaha sab leela koilo Sri Nandan Andan. Actually, there are so many pastime places, how many can you explain? So he says, Yaha sab leela koilo Sri Nandan Andan. Means so many pastimes happened in this place, Sri Brajbhumi, Vrindavan Dham or Mathura Mandal. So the leelas, the pastimes and the pastime places are so many that they can't be described properly. So they have to be summarized in one sentence. Just like there is this beautiful bhajan by Vallabhacharya, Adharam Madhuram. So Vallabhacharya wrote this bhajan right here where we are sitting now. When Srinathji appeared here, Vallabhacharya used to worship him every day. And all of his bhajan, most of his bhajans he has written here. So in that bhajan, the first verse, he is saying, Adharam Madhuram. Actually, Vallabhacharya is, in his meditation, he is seeing Krishna. And he is saying, Adharam Madhuram, means Krishna's lips, they are full of sweetness. And when you see one body part of Krishna, then the attention goes to the next. So when Vallabhacharya in his meditation is seeing the lips of Krishna, then he sees his face, Vadanam Madhuram. Then when he sees the face, he sees the eyes of Lord Krishna, who are always moving in all directions, left, right, bottom, you know, upside, downside, just like a fish. Then he says, Nayanam Madhuram. And when he sees the lotus eyes, then he sees the smile of Krishna. He says, Hasitam Madhuram. And Krishna in this way is reciprocating with Vallabhacharya. And Vallabhacharya is so pleased with reciprocation of Krishna in his heart. He says, Hridayam Madhuram. And when Vallabhacharya sees Krishna in his Hridaya, so he tries to catch him, you know. It is natural. It is also explained in the pastimes of Bilwa Mangal Thakur. When Bilwa Mangal Thakur would see Krishna in his meditation, he would try to catch him and Krishna will run away. Similarly, Vallabhacharya, when he sees Krishna in his heart and he says, Hridayam Madhuram, so Krishna starts running away. Then Vallabhacharya says, Gamanam Madhuram. Even when Krishna is going away, that is also Madhuram. So whatever Krishna does is full of sweetness. From head to toe, he is a personification of complete sweetness. And so the glory of Vrindavan Dham is unlimited, but what is Vrindavan without its devotees? So that's why after this, after the first three verses in this bhajan, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami starts speaking about the devotees. Nanda Yashoda Jaya Jaya Gopa Gana So definitely Vrindavan Dham is the super excellent dham, but without the devotees, what is the charm in it? And Krishna's eternal associates are the ones who directly come from Goloka with him, and they are the ones who set all the pastimes in motion. Like Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Mataji, their glories can't be described even by the Vedas, by the great saints. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Parikshit Maharaj is asking that what pious or the auspicious activities Nanda Maharaj has done that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is playing like an ordinary child in his courtyard, and what auspicious activities Mother Yashoda has done that the Supreme Lord who sits on the ocean of milk, he is taking milk from the breast of Mother Yashoda. So these things cannot be conceived. So once when one of the acharyas is explaining that how Mother Yashoda's love is so pure and without Aishwarya that she considers Krishna like just like an ordinary child. Once Krishna was sitting with Mother Yashoda, and Mother Yashoda, seeing his naughty nature, told him, "See Krishna, you should study Vedas." So Krishna said, "Vedas? What is that Veda? Who has written Vedas?" So Mother Yashoda says that the Supreme Lord himself, he has written the Vedas. So Krishna asks, "So what is explained in the Vedas?" Mother Yashoda says, "In the Vedas it is explained that how great is Bhagwan." So Krishna asks, "So how great is Bhagwan?" So Mother Yashoda says, "Bhagwan is Vibhu, you know, he is unlimited." So Krishna says, "So Mother, what will I gain by reading the Vedas?" So Mother says, "You will get liberation by reading the Vedas." So Krishna says that, "But by getting liberation, what will I get?" So Krishna says that, "By getting liberation, you will get the Supreme Ananda." So Krishna doesn't seem to understand what she's saying. And he sees one butter pot lying nearby, and he picks the butter pot and he starts eating the butter. And he tells Mother Yashoda, "See Mother Yashoda, this is Ananda, you know. This butter pot, this is Ananda. So I don't have to study Vedas. I'm already having Ananda." So like this, there are wonderful pastimes in Vrindavan Dham with Lord Krishna's eternal associates. So the time's up. Just to wind up, I want to read this one sentence from Srila Prabhupada's purport. Srila Prabhupada says, "Therefore anyone living in Navadvip Dham, knowing Krishna and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to be the same personality, lives in Brajabhumi, Mathura, Vrindavan. The Lord has made it convenient for the conditioned soul to live in Mathura, Vrindavan and Navadvip, and thus be directly connected with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Srila Prabhupada is explaining that how Navadvip and Vrindavan are non-different. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is a very interesting verse which also says, it gives a similar message about the pastimes of Lord Krishna and pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. So we'll conclude with this verse. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, "Chaitanya Leela Amritapura, Krishna Leela Sukarpura, Duhe Mili Haya Sumadhurya, Sadhu Guru Prasade Tatha Yai Aswade, Sei Jane Madhurya Prachura." So Chaitanya Leela Amritapura, Krishna Leela Sukarpura. So Krishnadas Kaviraj is saying that Chaitanya Leela is very sweet, like Amrit. And Krishna Leela is like a Karpur, which is added to that already sweet Amrit. And when these two are mixed, then Duhe Mili Haye Sumadhurya. Then it gives rise, or it makes a very amazing sweet. It has such a sweetness which is inconceivable. But how that sweetness can be conceived? He says, Sadhu Guru Prasade Tatha Yai Aswade. One who tastes that sweetness by the mercy of Sadhu and Guru. So only by hearing these pastimes by the mouth, by the vani of Sadhu and Guru, Sai Jane Madhurya Prachur, he is able to understand the depths of the sweetness of this wonderful sweet of Chaitanya Leela and Krishna Leela. So we are very, very fortunate to stay in this Mathura Mandal, where all the great personalities have done tapasya. They are eager to come here as mountains, as blades of grass. And like we read in Govardhana Vas Prarthana Dashakam every day, that by order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has sent me here, although I'm not qualified. This Raghunath Das Goswami is saying. So definitely we also don't have the qualification to stay here. But by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Srila Prabhupada, we are staying here. So let us take this wonderful opportunity, and all of you should bless me also that I take this opportunity seriously to stay here at the lotus feet of Giriraj and absorb myself in the pastimes of different holy places and also the associates of the Lord. Hare Krishna. Shri Vrindavan Dham ki jai, Shri Mathura Mandal ki jai, Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapuran ki jai, Itai Gaura Premanandeya.